It's present in the book of Matthew, chapter 23, verses 11, 12. Read, "The greatest among you will be your servant. For those who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who humble themselves will be exalted." I arrive today to recognize five of Montana's greatest servants, five Montana heroes. Our state has faced severe flooding, unrelenting flooding, for the past several weeks. Water levels rising, Montanans across the state stepping up to help. This is the essence of what it means to be a Montanan, stepping up to help fellow Montanans. Ordinary folks doing extraordinary things for their friends and neighbors. We are all in this together. That's why I've begun calling attention to Montana heroes going above and beyond the call of duty in the floods that we are experiencing in our state today. I want to recognize Pastor Cathy Moorehead of the United Methodist Church and Father Daniel Wathan of St. Benedict's Church of Roundup. Last week, Cathy and Daniel showed me the flood damage caused by rising waters from the nearby Musselshell River. Most of the town of Roundup has been underwater for days. I remember many times I've gone to the Busy Bee Cafe in Roundup. Never in my wildest dreams I ever think that that restaurant might be underwater. Today, a few days ago it was, floods have come back again. It's not entirely underwater, but so much of it is, it's just virtually destroyed. Cathy and Daniel took it upon themselves to make sure their neighbors had a hot meal, a dry place to sleep, medical care, a shoulder to cry on. And it's food not only for those who are displaced by the floods, but also for the National Guard. So the National Guard doesn't have to eat all those MRAPs, those rations that they otherwise would have to eat. I talked to the guard, they're so appreciative. They don't have to eat that food they otherwise would be given. Ask anyone around up, they'll tell you that Cathy and Daniel's outstanding efforts continue to be indispensable. Flood waters have returned to Roundup, and our prayers are with them all today. This month, the Crow Indian tribe also faced devastating floods. Rising water has severed food and water supplies. No drinking water. Rushing water has swept away bridges, streets. As soon as the floodwaters struck the Crow Reservation, Crow tribe member April Twanita got to work. April worked with the Red Cross to set up shelter for food victims. She made sure the Indian Health Service had the latest information about where medical care was most urgently needed. She was universally recognized as the go-to person for help. April Twanita. April has been working 18-hour days, sleeping on the floor of the Crow Housing Authority, doing whatever it takes to help her community. April's hard work inspires all of us to help each other through the floods in any way we can. When Box Elder burst its banks, floodwaters destroyed the Harris family north of Mill Iron, just outside of Ekalakwa. Neighbors Charlie and Gail Brentz hopped on four-wheelers and went to rescue the Harris family of seven. When they arrived, the Harris home was under 6 feet of water, rapidly rising. They offered the Harris family a warm and safe place to stay, a shoulder to cry on, and a helping hand as they have worked to save their cattle and salvage personal belongings from the destroyed homes. Gail Brentson said, "We're Montanans. This is what we do." Pastor Cathy, Father Dan, April, Charlie, and Gail are the best of the best Montana has to offer. They represent our can-do attitude, our willingness to help our neighbor, and our belief is that when times are tough, we know that we are the strongest when we work together. There are hundreds of other unsung heroes across Montana, and I'm calling on all Montanans to share their stories of ordinary folks doing extraordinary things for their friends and neighbors. Whether on Facebook or by call my office, we want to hear these inspiring stories. We want to share them. You know, some folks in our state say it's somewhat true that Montana is really one big town. We tend to know each other. We're big in area, few in people, but we tend to know each other, about 1 or 2 degrees of separation. We're really one big, small town. We're there to help each other. So in closing, Mr. President, I want to share a humble thank you for all the Montana's heroes back home. I don't know what we'd do without you. Thank you for your service.